Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. In my last video, I showed you how to do this buttonhole filling stitch. In Marathi, we call it the zaalicha taka or the netted stitch, and it is actually the buttonhole filling stitch. So today I'm going to show you a buttonhole filling stitch which is detached. I have done it here halfway through so that I can show you what is the difference between this and this. So here we are picking up the fabric, but here we are going to do it detached. So I haven't picked up any fabric. See, if you can understand what I mean, I can insert my finger here because I haven't picked up any fabric. So though it is a buttonhole filling, it is not like this, it is different. So I'm going to show you this buttonhole detached filling stitch in this particular shape. Now for that, the method is again the same. Just like here, I will do an outline with stem stitch first. And I have just drawn guidelines here to know where I have to do the horizontal stitch. I'll show you what I mean by that once I start doing it. So let me first begin by doing a stem stitch outline. Here you can also do an outline with chain stitch, but I'm going to do it with a stem stitch. I prefer the stem stitch for the outline, but you can do a split stitch or a chain stitch or a reverse chain. It is your choice which stitch you want to do the outline with. Yesterday I got a request from one of the viewers to make the videos in Hindi, so I'm definitely going to give it a try. I can do the video in Hindi also, just that it can take a little while because when I shoot the video, I'm recording it in English, but to dub it in Hindi, it may take me a little while, but I'm definitely going to give it a try. Just bear with me if it takes a little while for me to do it. I'm very glad by the feedback that I'm receiving on my channel. Please do keep sending me feedback so that I can improve my videos, the quality of the videos. Also, you can in the comment box let me know if you want to see any particular stitch being done, any particular stitch tutorial. If you want, you can send me a request in the comment section. I will try to incorporate it as soon as I can. I have done this detached buttonhole filling in that rectangle box to show you here, and I'm going to do it in this petal shape here so that you get an idea that it can be used in any shape. There is no restriction about what kind of stitch you can what kind of design you can use this stitch for. You can use it in any shape, doesn't matter. Okay, so my stem stitch outline is now done. My stem stitch outline is done here. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take the needle out from here, the first guiding line that I have drawn there, and I'm going to do this horizontal line. Okay, this is done. Now to start the buttonhole filling, I've started from this narrow end. You can also start from the other end actually. It is your choice. Now to start the buttonhole, I'm going to keep this thread here like this. I'm going to pass the needle from under this outline and from under this horizontal line to do a buttonhole. Again, I will do the same. If you do it from the other side, maybe I should have done that. That's okay, doesn't matter. Now, I'm sorry about the angle. Now this is my last buttonhole and I need to anchor it, so I'm going to put the needle down. Now I will bring the needle up here on the next guiding line, next horizontal line. Put put it down here where my horizontal line is, and I will follow the same pattern. Now I will bring the needle out here close to where I have put it down. Now this time when I'm doing the buttonhole, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the needle from under this buttonhole stitch in the previous row. See, this is the first stitch, so under it, and under this horizontal line as well, and pull it through. Now this is the next one, so I'm going to put it under and here. Note that I'm not picking up any fabric. Again, under this buttonhole, under this horizontal line, and pull through. I have not picked up any fabric under this buttonhole, under the horizontal line, pull through. Last one here, under this buttonhole, under the horizontal line, and pull through. So no fabric picked up. Now since this was the last one, you can anchor it down by putting the needle down. Now move to the next horizontal stitch, horizontal line, put it down here, and keep following the same pattern. Now here my line has come slightly tilted. It can be actually same, evenly spaced, it doesn't matter, it still works. So under the previous, see here, under this buttonhole, under the horizontal stitch, pull through. Under the second buttonhole. So you follow the same pattern where you are doing, first of all, create this loop here. Then in the previous row, you go under the buttonhole loop, then under the horizontal line that you have done, and pull through. Again, under the next buttonhole, under the horizontal, and pull through. Last one, under the buttonhole here, under this one, and pull through. And to anchor it, you take it down and continue this with all the further horizontal lines that we have drawn. So I'm going to take it offline and I'll finish this and I'll come back and show you how it looks. Okay, so as you can see, I have finished the whole petal and this is how it looks. So this was the buttonhole stitch filling and this is the detached buttonhole stitch filling, which means it is hollow like this. So there is no fabric being picked up. So everything is on the surface. So let me show you the back side. See, on the back side, there's nothing because it is detached buttonhole. Now here I have I started it from this side and then finished it like this. Alternatively, you can also do it the other way around. You can start it like this and keep filling and then come here and do the last. That is entirely your choice, what orientation you want to do the stitch in, but this is how it looks. So I hope you understood how to do the detached buttonhole stitch. And I'm sure it is very easy even for a beginner. So do give it a try. And let me know in the comments box if you tried. And let me know how you found it. Thank you for watching.